joining us online this morning, we just welcome you especially. And you can follow the lessons using the link provided in the description of this live stream. Please let us know you're here by leaving a prayer request, a thanksgiving, or even just a hello in the comments. If you'd like to find out more about St. Christopher's, I'd invite you to reach out to us through our social media channels or through the email or telephone you'll find on our website. As more and more people are vaccinated, we hope that we'll see you in person soon as you feel comfortable. And if you have been blessed by this ministry, I'd ask you to consider supporting St. Christopher's using the links in the description of this video. Holy Eucharist Rite 2 begins on page 355 of the Book of Common Prayer. Please stand. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our Lord. first letter of John. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey His commandments, and His commandments are not burdensome, for whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, than to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. We're celebrating a number of things today, not the least of which is the sixth Sunday of Easter. We are barreling through Easter. It seems like it was just the other day we were about the third Sunday of Lent. But here we are. It's the sixth Sunday of Easter. We're getting ready for those great mysteries of the Ascension and Pentecost, which we will celebrate next week and the week after. Not only are we celebrating that today we're celebrating a number of things. We're celebrating our graduates. We will be graduating from college, high school, this spring. We'll have a prayer for them, but we're also celebrating Mother's Day, the day when we honor our mothers. And we spend a lot of time talking about God the way we talk about our mothers. Like a hen gathers her brood, right? So it's a motherly and a fatherly love that comes out all through the Scriptures. So what are we to say? Are we to say that God is like a mother? What does that mean? Of course, when we think of mothers, we think of love. We think of unconditional love. We think of a love that moves first. But we don't think of a perfect love, because really, when we talk about love, we're talking about God. John says today, God is love. Not that God loves, not that love is something God does from time to time, not that love is something God falls in and out of. God is, this is the thing that he does. The thing that God does. In fact, that's kind of his whole trick. Everything that God has done, you can say, is an act of love. But how do we put our minds around that? I think one of the ways is that God has given us examples of this. Most of us, our mothers are like God. We say the same thing about our fathers as God our Father. Because everything only approaches the love that God says he has for us. It's the basis of the commandments. By his own name, he calls himself love. Everything else flows from him. That's why Jesus says to us, "You are my friends and you keep my commandments." You keep the commandments, you abide in the love. The love that Augustine says is closer to you than you are to yourself. Spend our lives thinking about that, trying to approach that kind of love. And like the mother, God will find a way to love us. More to the point, think of your own mothers. If your mother has found a way to love you, in most times it might not have been as easy. But love is the thing that God does, and so he finds a way. In spite of how we think love ought to work, in spite of falling in love, in spite of what our feeling on any given day might be about someone or for someone, love is the constant. Love finds a way to show us God. And so abiding in love, abiding in that commandment, that new commandment, that you love one another, not the golden rule, right? The golden rule is love your neighbor as yourself, or do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And Father Casey this week called it the platinum rule. In case don't know how to love yourself as well as you should, love like I have loved you, says Jesus. Love as I have loved you. Love in the perfect love. Not what you're feeling today, but love the way that I do. That's how we go from being servants to friends. It's how we live the life God has called us to. God will find a way to make that life work for us. God will find a way to show us that he loves us. But it comes down to God showing himself to us through Jesus Christ as love. Not just a being that loves, but love itself. And love that embraces each one of us and calls us to love each other in that way, to embrace neighbor at the world the way God has loved us. Happy Mother's Day. Happy graduation to those of you who are going forward. Happy 6th Sunday of Easter. Happy Easter season. Love one another as God's love. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him.
Father, we pray for your Holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their stress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let thy perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in the kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and for those of others.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you." Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church. And give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and with the Holy Spirit you live and reign now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Be seated for just a moment. Got a few things going on this week. First, I would like to, as I mentioned, it is Mother's Day, so if you are able to stand, I would like you to bless our mothers. You may be seated, that's fine as well. But I would like to say this blessing for you today. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you give life and care for your church. Bless these women as we celebrate this day in their honor. May they be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor and appreciate them with a spirit of profound respect. May the example of Mary, Mother of Jesus, inspire them to live their vocation as Christian mothers and call their children to faith. Guide and protect them in challenging times and help them to continue to trust in you all the days of their life. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, mothers. Now, lots going on today. George, I know you've just graduated. Anybody else? I feel like Oral Roberts has to have you put your hand on the television screen and graduate and receive the blessing. George, Stan will bless you and through you all of your fellow graduates. Loving God, we thank you for all who graduated this time of the year. You have blessed them during their years in school with wisdom, friendships, and skills. You continue to challenge them to make this world a better place because of their education. Help them look forward to their next steps, continuing in their education or entering the work world. Particularly help those who are seeking employment to find a job suitable to their education. Give them faith and a sense of purpose in their next steps. Show them how to serve others in effective ways. And may they be always aware in everything they do that they will find fulfillment in doing your will, that you will be with them always, and that you will bring to completion the good work you have begun in them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Speaking of schools, tomorrow's a big day for St. Christopher's. The Montessori school that has been closed since last March is opening tomorrow. So we're looking forward to having critters around. It will be great. So the teachers over there have worked really hard for this. In next week's email, we'll have a picture of all of them so that as you come by, you can say hi to them and introduce yourself and let them know just how great a work they're doing, not just for St. Christopher's, but for the children that we are ministering ministered to through our school, which is the biggest ministry that we have here, the biggest outreach to our community that we do so far. So we're looking forward to that. Also want to thank everyone yesterday who came for the work day. I was not able to make it. My wife took a little spill, so we were dealing with that. But thank you for everyone who was able to come, and we will. It looks great. Getting ready for the day, for tomorrow, and for the coming weeks. Very grateful for all of you who put that time and effort into getting our campus ready. The parish hall looks great. The classrooms look great. We'll open it up after if you want to go. Just poke your head in and take a look. It looks like a completely different space now if you haven't seen it yet. I do hope you'll do that. So thank you again for all of those who have done that. This week, Wednesday, is again our approach series. This week we have Father Keith Turboville, who is from Holy Trinity in Keith. He'll be joining us to look at the scriptures for next Sunday, when we will be transferring the Feast of the Ascension to the Sunday. So we'll look forward to having him with us. If you haven't had a chance to join us on that, I encourage you to look at that. Take a look and be with us either live on Wednesday mornings through the link that is in your email. We can also send out a reminder on Tuesdays or in our YouTube channel. So please take a look. Scribes to the Lord, we honor to his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts.
Joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven who forever sing
proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable to him, through him being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, as the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Christ incumbent, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.